So this is where it gets to be super awesome. And by that, I don't mean that. This is where everybody's brain starts to get addled. We're going to talk about stretching and smooshing, and I have no idea what your textbooks actually say this is, because this is the only way that I can think about it that it makes sense. All right, so you'll see up on the right, we have an A in front of our f of x. We said anything outside the f is an up and down. So we know whatever that A is doing, it has something to do with an up, down, something or other. So what that A actually does is it stretches by a factor of A. So I guess you could put all these in one category, but if A is greater than one, it's going to be a stretch, and if A is less than one, it's going to be a smush. So we're going to focus on the stretch part first. So say we've got a triangle, and we have 2 times a triangle. Anything that's not on the x-axis. So we've got, I'm basically going to use some points so you can kind of see what's going on. But anything that's on the x-axis is going to stay put. Anything that's not on the x-axis is going to get stretched by a factor of 2. So that point is currently 2 above the x-axis. So since it's 2 above the x-axis, 2 times 2 is 4. So now it's going to be 4 above the x-axis. So we're going to stretch it up to 4. So that's kind of a double stretch. The things on the x-axis stay where they are, otherwise it stretches up. You can already tell this is going to be really fun, right? All right. So here we've got 2 f of x again, just to show you how it looks. All right, we've got our 3 points that we're kind of paying attention to. And if you just pick a couple of points on your graph, whatever it looks like, and just kind of keep track of them as you go through this, it does make it a little bit easier. So none of those points are on the x-axis, so they're all available to be stretched. So the 2 on the bottom are at minus 1. We multiply that 2, that means they're going to go down to minus 2. And the one on the top is at plus 1. If we multiply by 2, that becomes plus 2. So you're basically doubling the distance it is from the x-axis. So you're stretching it outward. You've got the same shape, actually. If you go look at what we had in the previous slide, it's the same shape. The position is just different. And this is why order really matters when you do this. This is when order is really going to get you if you haven't been paying attention to that. Now, vertical smush, as we said, is any time that a is less than 1, it's going to get smushed by that factor. So if you had 1/2, now anything that's not on the x-axis is going to get smushed toward the x-axis. So here we've got these points are going to stay where they are, but this one up here, it's at 2. So I'm going to multiply it times 1/2 to get 1, and then I'm going to smush it down toward there. So it's now 1/2 as tall as it was before. Works even no matter how your triangle is positioned. So again, 1/2 x, anything that's not on the x-axis is going to get moved toward the x-axis. So you're smushing it by 1/2. So things that are at 1 become at 0.5. Things that are at negative 1 become at negative 0.5. So I'm going to smush it just like that. Now, the next thing is extraordinarily annoying because it's counterintuitive. So this is kind of good. Anything inside the parenthesis is the opposite of what you're going to expect it to be. Anything outside the parenthesis is exactly what you would hope it would be. So here's the problem. So before, if our factor was greater than 1, it gave us a stretch. When we're going left to right, it gives us a smush. So if I have f of 2x and the 2's on the inside, that's not stretching it by 2 left to right, that's actually smushing it by 1/2. So, anything that's not on the y-axis is going to get smushed. So, anything on the y-axis there, those points there, they're going to stay where they are. This guy here, he's going to get smushed. So, even though it's 2x and you're like, oh, 2 means it gets big. No, anything on the inside of the parenthesis is completely backwards, which is super fun, and it's going to get smushed. All right? So now we have a smushed triangle. Same thing, same example here, basically, just showing you anything that's not on the y-axis is going to get smooshed like that. Here we go with a horizontal stretch. Now, of course, if a big number smooshes it, a smaller number is going to stretch it. So 1 over 1/2 is 2. So our stretch factor is now 2. Anything not on the y-axis is going to find itself twice as far from the y-axis as it was before. And so again, here our stretch factor is 2. Anything not on the y-axis is going to find itself twice as far from the y-axis as it was before.